Hello everyone, I'm Xiaoyan Liu from Beihang University. Now I will introduce our work toward accelerated stencil computation by adapting tensor core units on GPU. The presentation is organized as 5 sections. First, I will introduce the background and motivation, and then I will present our design and method. After that, I will present the evaluation results, and finally, I will show some related works and make a conclusion. First, I will present the background and motivation, including introduction to stencil computation and the tensor core. The stencil computation is one of the well-known computation pattern derived from the Feynman difference method, which is widely used in various scientific applications. To update a point, which is called the center point in the mesh, the stencil computation calculates the weighted sum of the center points and its neighborhoods. Figure A and Figure B shows 5-point star stencil and 9-point box stencil, respectively, where the star and box are the shape of stencil, and the distance between the center point and its farthest neighbor is denoted as the radius of the stencil. Tiling is one of the most efficient optimization to accelerate stencil computation, which divides the input mesh into several submeshes. And the tiling introduces different regions of the submesh, which is shown in the figure by different color. And the points can be updated by the point inside the submesh in the inner mesh. And the point that requires the point of adjacent the mesh is boundary region, and the point needed by the boundary region is the header region. On the other hand, with the popularity of GM applications such as deep learning, existing and emerging processors have commonly adopted tensor core units for accelerated GM application. And the tensor core is designed for accelerating matrix multiply and accumulate operation. The GPU processor has been recognized as a ideal platform for accelerating stencil computation due to their massive parallelism and high bandwidth. The NVIDIA GPU introduced Tensor Core for Volta, and the following architectures such as Ampere also adopts Tensor Core. When used MP16 Tensor Core, they can achieve 125 teraflops and 312 teraflops respectively. And the tensor core of NVIDIA GPU can be programmed as a warp level with CUDA, warp matrix multiply and accumulate API, which is MMMA API. And this API provides a specific function to load input matrix, perform the MMA operation, and store the result max. In particular, the size of the matrix is constrained to several settings. Although the tensor core can greatly accelerate GM application, they are difficult to benefit non-GM application. Existing work have explored the tensor core for accelerated scan and reduction by constructing special form of GM. For example, as shown in equation 1 and equation 2, the reduction can be realized by 2 GM operations on the tensor core. However, this method is hard to be used for stencil computation because the irregular computation patterns of the stencil and thus accelerating the stencil permutation with tensor chroma has not been exploited yet. In this paper, we propose a general method, TC stencil, to efficiently explore the tensor coordinate for stencil computation by redesigning its calculation procedure. Next, I will present our design and method. In this paper, we assume that the size of gym supported by the tensor coordinate is L multiply L and multiply L. The input of the stencil is the matrix A, and the output of the stencil is the matrix B. And we use A prime, whose shape is L multiply L, present a sub mesh of the input mesh. And A prime is well the input matrix of the tensor coordinate. Note that we assume the L is bigger than 2R plus 1, where R is the radius of the stencil. We use the lowercase and number to present the coefficients of stencil. The figure shows the coefficients for 9-point star stencil and 25-point box stencil. To simplify the illustration, we consider 2D stencil in this paper. As for 3D stencil, one can first apply the string strategy and then perform our method on the 2D size graph from the 3D mesh. Then I will introduce how to use tensor core to compute stencil computation. Our key idea is to regarding the stencil as a summation of the reduction of slides. We'll introduce how to adopt tensor coordinate to star stencil first. Taking 9-point star stencil as an example, the star stencil can be pressed at the summation of 2YT reduction. Thus, the computation of a star stencil can be split into 3 steps. The step 1 is to calculate the reduction result of vertical slides. The step 2 is to calculate the reduction result of the horizontal slides. And step 3 is to sum the result of the vertical slides and the horizontal slides. A straightforward approach is leveraging the tensor coordinate to accelerate the weighted reduction using the method proposed in the SAS 19 to calculate the reduction for the step 1 and step 2. For step 1, we can store the vertical coefficient, which is V1 to V5, a matrix called PV, and the PV is the parameter matrix used to compute the vertical slides, and we leave the rest of the elements in PV 0. And then we can perform gym for PV and A prime. Then we can get the reduction result of the vertical slides and we store the results in the matrix P1. In the same way, for the step 2, we can store the horizontal coefficient, which is from H1 to H5 in PH. The PH is the horizontal matrix for the horizontal slides. And then, we can perform gym for submesh and pH. Then we can get the reduction results of the horizontal slides and restore it in result matrix T2. Then we can add T1 and T2 and get the final result of distance computation. Although this method can use tensor unit, the strict approach can lead to low tensor core unit utilization. This is because two gym kernel on the tensor core unit are launched for acting on the one point of the input mesh. And the most of the input value in the tensor core unit are zero. To address this problem, we propose a new parameter matrix in order to contain several vertical slides or horizontal slides within a single gym kernel on tensor core unit. As shown in the figure, we store V1 to V5 in row R plus 1 to row L minus R of the PV, and we store H1 to H5 in column R plus 1 to column L minus R of the parameter of horizontal, and we leave in the rest of the parameter matrix to be zero. And using this new parameter matrix, we can calculate several vertical slides or horizontal slides of inner point of A prime within a single gym kernel. And the figure shows how the new parameter matrix calculates the stencil computation. For the any point Im in the inner region, the first gym can calculate the reduction of the vertical slides and we store its result in TYMN. And the second gym calculates the reduction of the horizontal slides and we store the result in T2MN. Then we add the two results and get the final stencil result. Then we demonstrate the method can calculate all vertical slides or horizontal slides of the inner points of A prime within a single gym kernel on the tensor core unit. Taking the first gym, for example, when the rth row vector, which is the fourth non-zero row vector of the PV, multiplies the submesh A prime, the reduction result of the vertical slice is the smallest row number and the length of 2r plus 1 in A prime can be derived, which are the vertical results needed by the first row of the inner region of A prime. Similarly, when the last non-zero row of PV multiplies the submesh, we can get the stencil result of the last row of the inner region of A prime. Thus, we can compute all the vertical results of the inner region. Note that the process is expanded by row for better illustration, which is accurately calculated by one gym operation. And to further improve the utilization of the tensor core unit, we put partial coefficients in all zero row column of PV and PH respectively. As shown in the figure, we fill the parameter matrix with more coefficients which are the coefficient of partial horizontal and vertical sines. Then we can use this particle coefficient to compute the partial results of the weighted reduction across all required points, which can be used to update the stencil result of the boundary region of A prime. Taking the first gene, for example, in the first row of PV multiply the first column of A prime, we can get the partial result of the point 1,1 in the sub mesh, which is colored in yellow. And as for the reduction of the remaining points, which are colored in green, one can use FMA, the flows multiply and add unit, to perform the other particle result and add the reduction result to the output matrix from gene operation. Next, when the second row of PV multiplies the first column of A prime, we can get the partial results needed by the 0.21 in the sum mesh, which is currently yellow. Also, the remaining points can be computed by FMA. Finally, our partial result of vertical slice needed by the sub mesh can be obtained by the first gem operation. In the same way, the second gem operation also can obtain all partial horizontal result of the sub mesh. In this way, we can maximally plot the tensor unit utilization in this tensor computation. Then, I will introduce how to compute the box tensor using the tensor unit. In the same way, the computation of the box tensor can be represented as a weighted reduction of a series of horizontal slides or vertical slides. Since the approach of using horizontal slides or vertical slides is the same, we present the box tensor as a series of horizontal slides in this paper as an example. We construct one parameter matrix for the reduction of each horizontal slice. Taking the 25 points box stencil, for example, we conduct 5 parameter matrix from PA, PB to the PE, where the PA is used to get the first horizontal slice result, and PE is used to get the fifth horizontal result. However, using the same gem strategy with the star stencil directly leads to mistake. As shown in the figure, we can perform the first gem operation on the tensor core unit to obtain TA to get the first horizontal slide result. Then, we want to get the second horizontal result by the second gem operation. However, sum of TA and TB will lead to incorrect result. This is because the first column of PB are the coefficients required by the reduction of the second row of A prime. And the figure on the right shows the correct result we needed. To address the above problem, we change the starting position of each gem operation. For example, first, we load A prime, which is colored in light green from the first row of the input mesh. Then we perform gene to get the result of the first horizontal slice of box stencil. We store the results in TA. Then for the second gene, we move in prime one row down below the input mesh, and the coefficients of PB is multiplied by the second row of the input mesh correctly. In this way, we can get all the correct horizontal result, and we can sum TA, TB to TE to get the correct stencil result. Last but not least, our method only relies on the gene operation of the tensor core unit and doesn't depend on other architectural features. Therefore, it can be easily applied to other processor with tensor core units. We use tensor core to implement the star stencil and box stencil with radius 1 and radius 2 ampere and water, limited by the tensor core of the NVIDIA GPU. We use MMA to perform gene in FP16 and gene shape is 16 multiply 16 and 16. And we perform several optimizations for GPU architecture, including tiling and using shared memory. We also redesigned the data layout for tensor core, shown in the figure, where the distance between two adjacent A primes can be large if we use more major layout. To address this problem, we redesign the data into 16 multiply 16 submatrices and store the elements of the A prime in row major order. In this way, we can improve the data locality and reduce memory access latency. Note that the sum matrix only changes the address indexing in the standard computation, so it doesn't introduce extra memory access during the runtime. Next, I will present our evaluation. We evaluate both star stencil and box stencil with radius 1 and radius 2 in different mesh sets. We use duration matrix from NVIDIA Ansible Profiler to record the extraction time and use updated points per second to present the performance. The hardware and software information are present in the table. To better understand the performance improvement enabled by the tensor core, we compare the stencil code optimized with the TC stencil using the tensor core, which is denoted at TC, and the TC stencil without using tensor core, which is denoted at TC without TC. Both the implementation adopt the same thread configuration and some optimization, such as the data redesign, shared memory, tiling, and use the same compiler optimizations. Comparing the performance between TC and without TC, it is clear that using tensor core can significantly improve the performance of stencil computation. As the input mesh size increased, the resources of the SDM are limited, so TC Stencil have better performance thanks to the high throughput of TensorFlow. The height speedup can achieve 1.69, which is achieved on the VUTA and the 9-point star stencil. We also compare TC Stencil with three state-of-the-art stencil optimization frameworks on GPU, including Artemis, N5D, and Brick. Specifically, none of these frameworks support stencil computation in FP16 positions. To ensure a fair comparison, we convert the optimized stencil code from these frameworks into the FP16 position. As a result, TC Stencil achieves significant speedup to these three stencil frameworks. The average speedup range from 1.23 to 3.77, and the highest speedup range from 3.5 to 16.63. Relate the work and make a conclusion. The common stencil optimization, including spatial temporal tiling, streaming, unrolling, and some hardware-specific optimization, which have been explored by many works and some stencil frameworks. And there are few works using TensorCore unit for stencil computation by transforming stencil computation into supported algorithms on the TensorCore unit, such as the convolution and the sparse matrix multiplication. This work fought to consider the characteristics of the stencil computation when using the TensorCore unit, and thus can fully unitize the computation results of the TensorCore unit. Finally, I will make a conclusion. This paper presents the first work to use TensorCore unit to accelerate stencil computation. And we implement the TC Stencil on GPU, and we also perform some optimization to the implementation. And finally, our experiments show that the TC Stencil can achieve significant speedup compared to the state-of-the-art stencil optimization frameworks, Ampere and VUTA. This concludes the presentation, and thank you for listening.